Welcome to this project. In this video, we'll be comparing two different UI designs for a temperature and humidity display. First, a basic plain text UI, and then a more advanced and visually appealing interface generated using Lopaka. Lopaka makes it easy to design professional dynamic UIs for your projects. Let's dive into how we can use Lopaka to create a sleek and interactive display, bringing your data to life with custom graphics and smooth functionality. Visit lopaka.app, create a new project, set a title, select the platform. For the T-Display S3, choose TFT ESPi and specify the screen size. Select the text tool and add a text. The code will generate automatically. If you want to wrap the functions, enable the wrapper in code settings. Create a rectangle for the background. Adjust the properties as needed. Check Filled for Fill Color and use the color picker to select the desired color. Rename the layer and rearrange the layers for better organization. Lopaka offers various fonts with different sizes and styles. For this project, I'll stick with the Adafruit font. We can copy and paste elements, adjust the size of the font as needed. Select multiple items and adjust the position using the arrow keys. Merge the layers into a bitmap to paint on it. This will convert the layer to bitmap arrays. Double-click the bitmap to paint on it. Design the UI according to your needs and experiment with different colors to achieve the desired look. Lopaka allows you to flip and rotate bitmaps, giving you more flexibility in your design. For the temperature gauge, I drew a rectangle with a width of 300 pixels. Then, for each 10 degree value, I used 30 pixels. Add more details to the gauge and repeat the steps to refine the design. Add additional gauges for humidity and heat index to enhance the UI and make it more visually appealing. If needed, add more UI elements to make the design more engaging. As mentioned earlier, rename and rearrange the layers for better organization. If everything looks good, copy the code. Open Platform.io in VS Code, create a new project, give it a name, and select the LilyGo T-Display S3 board. select the Arduino framework and click Finish. Paste the code copied from Lopaka and remove any unwanted code. Include the necessary libraries to make the display work. You can find example codes and the correct libraries in LilyGo's GitHub. Copy the TFT ESPi library downloaded from GitHub into the lib folder of the project. Otherwise, the display won't work. Once everything is done, build and upload the code. Now the UI is ready. Add the sensor and necessary functions to make it work. First, I moved the bitmap files to a separate .h file for better organization, included the necessary bitmap and DHT libraries. Now, the void draw function is responsible for drawing the static UI elements like the background, labels, and borders on the screen. The dynamic UI is updated using the update dynamic UI function, which continuously updates the temperature, humidity, and heat index values on the screen. The progress bars and gauge adjust dynamically based on the sensor readings, giving a visual representation of the humidity, heat index, and temperature levels. Finally, the read sensor data function reads data from the DHT sensor, updating the temperature, humidity, and heat index values, which are then displayed on the screen.